Hey beauties, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing some of my June beauty favorites, and then I'm also going to unbox what's in the little Chanel bag behind me. So I recently shared my Best of Luxury Beauty 2021 so far video, which I will link down below in case you're interested. That's really the best place to see a comprehensive list of all of my favorite things. I do have a few other pieces that I haven't talked about yet, and they're really great, so I didn't want to miss out on the opportunity to share. But before we begin, I want to quickly tell you about the sale going on at Ana Luisa. They are offering 20% off site-wide, and they sent over a couple new pieces to celebrate. Today I'm wearing the Fortuna necklace. It's originally $75, but on sale it's $60. And there's no code needed, the 20% off just applies automatically. I think I always say, this is my new favorite piece, no, this is my new favorite piece, but truly this is one of my favorite necklaces at the moment. I just think it is so beautiful. The plating is 14 karat gold. It has this really pretty mother of pearl and evil eye design, and they do all of their plating in-house. That way they don't have to outsource and they can control all of the working conditions. And as I have told you guys before, Ana Luisa is 100% carbon neutral. They use a lot of recycled metals when possible, recycled packaging whenever they ship something out. Everything is well protected, well made, the highest quality. But it's nice that they also care about the environment as well. Here's the other new necklace they sent over. This is the Una. It's originally $85, but currently on sale for $68. And I love this little dainty circle design. It's really pretty. Everything looks very elegant and timeless. I know I can hold on to their jewelry for years and years. It's not gonna break because it's great quality. Of course, all of their pieces do come with a 1-year warranty if something was going to happen, but I've never had a piece of jewelry tarnish or break on me. I always find something really beautiful on their website, and they are constantly adding new styles. A lot of times if I see something amazing, it'll sell out really quickly because they produce everything in really small quantities. That way they can control the quality. So just something to keep in mind. If you see something you love, take advantage of the 20% off. Again, there is no coupon code, no discount code needed. It's just 20% off site-wide. I will link some of my favorite styles down below, and all of the information you need will be down below in the description box. Now, let's get into these beauty favorites. You know, I imagine there are going to be a lot of big sales this weekend. If I find any others that are interesting, I will link those down below as well. Because here in the States, we have Independence Day. We're celebrating July 4th, and I think a lot of people are probably off work on Monday. Here in Miami, we're all collectively hoping that we don't have a hurricane. No fireworks for us. Fireworks are not just everybody have a safe holiday weekend. But this first item that I have here in my hand, this has been such an amazing discovery. This is the KP Bump Eraser Body Scrub with 10% AHA. Still safe for sensitive skin. It's from First Aid Beauty. They sent this to me, I think, last year around this time whenever I first made Sephora Squad. I just didn't try this right away. Finally, a couple weeks ago, I opened it up. I must have just finished my microdermabrasion body scrub from Dr. Brandt. That's what I was using before this, and I love it. I think it's a fraction of the cost of the Dr. Brandt, and I like it better. And I like the fact that it's in a squeezy tube. I also have the Kopari coconut body scrub in my shower. Smells incredible. It has that coconut oil, so it leaves your skin feeling really nourished. It's beautiful, but that scrub comes in a jar and it's just a little bit more difficult. It's not as convenient to use, whereas this, it's kind of like toothpaste. It's just so easy. Now, this smell is very off-putting versus the Kopari that smells like heaven. This does not have a very nice smell. And I know it. There's nothing wrong with it because I opened the seal the first time I used it, so it's fresh. It's just not a great smelling product. That's okay. I think the brand really is formulated with sensitive skin in mind, so I think most of their products are fragrance-free, including this one, and it has that 10% AHA as well. Consider yourself warned, it smells bad. It doesn't matter. Even a product that doesn't smell good makes my favorites list because the grit is amazing. It really does feel like you are sloughing off that top layer of dead skin. It leaves your skin feeling so smooth, and I like to leave it on for a minute or two so that the AHA can do its magic, also help get rid of all of that dead skin. And whenever you rinse your body, then I like to go in with my Kopari body wash because that way I have the coconut smell. Your skin feels brand new. fresh, beautiful, glowing. I would not use this for the face. For the body, it's okay. For the face, I think it would probably be just way too harsh. But for the body, it's incredible. Doing some ASMR. Can you hear the crystals? Yes. Glycolic acid, lactic acid, the white pumice crystals. It also contains oatmeal to help soothe the skin. And I've never had a bad reaction. The smell is terrible. I've never been red or irritated afterwards. It just leaves your skin feeling so smooth, gets rid of all of the texture, all of the bad dead skin cells. If you have any trips planned, if you plan to do a lot of sunless tanning over the summer because maybe you have events, you're going places, you're out and about this year, you're going to need a good body exfoliator, and I cannot recommend this enough. It's so good. And that's not the only product I pulled straight from the bathroom. This is the Shantikai Rice and Geranium Foaming Cleanser. I've been using this for probably, I would say, close to 2 months, maybe longer. A little bit is all you need. It reminds me a bit of the Chanel Le Mousse, except it doesn't sting or burn at all if it gets close to my eyes. I love this. I always like to double cleanse, so I'll go in with my Pharmacy Green Clean. I'm currently using the Green Clean Apple. Smells really great. I'll use that to remove most of my face makeup, and then I like to go in with this cleanser, and then it kind of gets rid of everything. It's so nice because I feel like it really balances the skin. It gives a nice kind of creamy lather. So many people recommend this to me, and it wasn't until kind of recent that I tried it out. For years, I've heard people talking about this cleanser, and it used to sell out constantly. They could never keep it in stock. Whenever I worked at Nordstrom, people would come in and they would buy two or three at a time because they just never wanted to be without it. Well, now I completely understand why, because it is truly so gentle. And then the last product I pulled from the shower is this Olaplex number 8 Bond Intense Moisture Mask. I love this mask. I picked this up during the Spring Sephora Savings event, and I waited a little bit to use it because I have so many masks in my bathroom. I love testing out new hair masks. I tried it out, I think once or twice by itself, and I liked it. I definitely liked it. I wasn't overly impressed. There were other masks that I preferred. Well, I recently started using this mask in conjunction with my Olaplex number 3. This is the killer combination. You have to use them together in order to get the full benefits of both. I, of course, love Olaplex number 3. I definitely recommend this for anybody with bleached hair, color-treated hair, if it's chemically treated, even if you maybe just have some heat damage and you're looking to help bond build, that is what this does. But with any bond builder, you have to pair it with hydration. The two go hand in hand. You need protein, you also need hydration. If you don't get the hydration and you're just doing a lot of protein treatments like this, it becomes brittle in that it just kind of snaps. The last few times I've done these together, I can notice a huge difference in the feel of my hair. It feels so soft and smooth. It feels hydrated but strong. Just the best combination. Really feels balanced the way it should be. So if you're using number 3, I definitely would pick up a number 8. Now, I haven't used this that many times, and I'm already more than halfway through the bottle. It's unfortunate, but I have to use 4 to 5 pumps in order to cover all of my hair. I have really long hair, so I like to do my Christoph Robin purple mask on top, and then I need a hydrating mask on the bottom. And I go through it. So if you have shorter hair, you might not run into that. It's $28, I believe, which isn't a terrible price point, especially considering some of the other masks I swear by, like the Kerastase mask, I want to say is closer to $60. So $28 is not terrible. Moving on now to makeup. I do have a couple pieces here. As I mentioned earlier, I did that Best of Luxury Beauty in 2021 so far video. That's where you'll find most of my favorite makeup. It will be linked. But I have tried a couple things since then, including these eyeliners from Chanel. Here I have the Rose Gold number 54. I'm just calling it Rose Gold because I can't pronounce that name. And then I also have the Or Antique number 48. This is basically just a yellow gold eyeliner. Both of these are incredible. I think these are going to be my new kind of daily wear eyeliners in the waterline. That's where I like to use these. They are soft enough that you can use them above the lash line. They don't drag. You can get a nice, really smooth line. You just have to make sure you sharpen them. So you lose a little bit of the product, unfortunately. But the majority of the time, I like to use these in the waterline, and I love the new shades they added. The gold is stunning. It doesn't look too yellow or too gold. It just kind of adds a little pop to the eye. I really think it makes your eye sparkle. And then this rose gold is really pretty. It almost looks burgundy, but depending on your eyeshadow look, kind of the makeup look overall, I think this is really stunning as well. I'm so happy these are not limited edition because as soon as I go through them, I will absolutely need to restock. In case anybody is curious, this is the rose gold, and I pulled out my romance eyeliner. And I'm going to swatch this right next to it. That way you can see the difference. There is a noticeable difference between the two, so you don't have to feel like you're duplicating if you already have this one. Romance is more of a coppery red, and the new rose gold is truly more of a rose eyeliner. It's really pretty. So I love these. I'm not including the two eyeshadow palettes, unfortunately. I really like them. They're not bad. I wouldn't call them a fail, but I don't know if they're my favorite things. As I said in my review, I actually prefer the Tender and Intensely beige eyeshadow palettes that came out earlier in the summer to the new recent palettes. I've only used the purple palette once. So, I'm going to play with it a couple more times and then I will be filming a review. So, that will be up very soon. Even this new Christian Louboutin palette, I think this is better than that Chanel brown and gold eyeshadow palette. This is what I'm wearing on my eyes today. These impressed me so much. They are so creamy and buttery and beautiful. They're just really easy to use. I know I mentioned it in my 2021 favorites video, but this is truly one of my favorite eyeshadow palette purchases of the year. Very unexpected. I wasn't sure what to think, but I'm so happy that it ended up being a really great purchase. I use this all the time. Keep it in the top drawer now. It's that good. I do have one other Chanel favorite from the month. This is the Le Lion de Chanel Illuminating Powder. I can't remember how many holiday seasons ago this was, but it was part of the Lion collection for holiday. It was so beautiful. They had this highlighter, I believe four single eyeshadows. I picked up two of them. This is so pretty. It is the most beautiful kind of antique gold on the skin. It's really nice over the summer because kind of has this peachy bronze undertone. Unfortunately, this one is no longer available. I double checked, but I've made it a point. My mission is to go through this highlighter. I've already finished one from Dior, which I didn't start it this year. I started it at the beginning of last year, and it took me a full year and then some to finish it. So this one is the next one. It's my little project. My goal is to finish another full highlighter and maybe an eyeshadow palette, like a quad from any brand. I don't care what brand it is, but I really just want to go through some of my makeup since I'm constantly buying new things. Unless I listed something else, this has been the highlighter I've been wearing lately. And when I did my highlighter collection video, I looked at the price versus the amount of product. And I was surprised to find that this highlighter actually had the least amount of product for the price. So I think I have a higher chance to actually use it up. I'm doing my best. And the line was so beautiful. Originally, I thought maybe it would be a collector's item, something that I would want to hold on to. But I used it for the review and I use it all the time now. So you can barely see the line. I did visit the Chanel website a couple weeks ago because I was looking for another Lion compact. They still have a couple of these left. When they launched that collection, they also came out with a few exclusive compacts. They were only available online, probably at the boutique at the time as well. And I picked up one of the remaining compacts. They had two shades. I think they're only down to one shade. This is Le Sein de Lion Illuminating Powder. What makes this one different is that it comes in a red compact. So let me show you. So this I purchased for collecting. I'm not going to use this. I'm not even going to swatch it. I don't have a lot of compacts like that, but there are, I think, three or four compacts from Chanel that I just don't touch. And this is going to join that collection. So this is the red compact. This one is Or Rose. So it's a rose gold finish. It looks so pretty. But I just love the lion emblem that's embossed on top. I love the red compact. So this is something that I'm just going to take pictures of and enjoy and add it to my collection of limited edition compacts. I wanted to make sure to show you and at least talk about it. That way, if any of you guys are interested in picking this up, you know that it is available for now. I think you have to search under exclusive items on Chanel.com. But the collection launched such a long time ago, I imagine this isn't going to be available for much longer. I also pulled out two perfumes, and I have so many favorite perfumes from the month of June, but since I do so many dedicated fragrance videos, I limited myself to only two. I wanted to make sure I had a variety, so I have an affordable option, and then this is my luxury niche price point. So the more affordable is this new Marc Jacobs Daisy Oh So Intense. This was sent to me complimentary a couple weeks ago, but it's a new launch for summer 2021, and I think this is so nice. It's very sweet, it's kind of a fruity floral, it has strawberry, honey, and moss. It smells like they took the original Daisy and then gave it a little attitude, like they kicked it up a notch. I think it is really pretty. If you love a fruity floral, if you like a sweet perfume, I think you will love this. If you're looking for new fragrances on a budget, definitely check this out. Now, if you're looking for something really special and you're okay to splurge, then I highly recommend the Roja Parfum 51 Essence Parfum. Cannot recommend it enough. This is going to be my number one fragrance for summer. I love this. It was obsession at first smell. I didn't even just love it. The first time I smelled this fragrance, it was like, this is it. What I've been searching for. When I showed my husband this perfume, he said he loved it. I showed close girlfriends. They also really love it. So I think this has mass appeal. I feel 100% confident recommending it. But you don't really find it that many places. I don't think I've ever visited a Roja Parfum counter. So unless you are kind of in the know or you find a way to discover it, somebody tells you about it, you're not really going to stumble upon this perfume. Which is kind of a good thing because then not a lot of people are going to have your fragrance and you'll just smell really good. Top notes are lemon, bergamot, and mandarin. Heart notes are lily of the valley, rose de mai, gardenia, orange blossom, jasmine, tuberose, and raspberry. Base notes are violet leaves, aniseed, cinnamon, clove, patchouli, cashmere wood, sandalwood, benzoin, vanilla, and orris. From start to finish, the first spray to the dry down hours later, it is perfection throughout. Just the best fragrance launch of 2021 so far. I try not to be too dramatic when I talk about my favorite fragrances because I have so many favorites, but truly, this was instantly one of the best in my collection, and if I could only wear one fragrance this summer, it would be 51. Easily. Wouldn't even have to think about it. And the last thing I have to share with you guys today is a little unboxing. I picked this up at the Chanel Boutique last week. I've visited the Chanel Boutique so many times in the last couple weeks because we had the new eyeshadow palettes and then the Chanel Factory 5 collection launched, and it has been so popular. I wasn't sure how it was going to go, and especially since they called it very limited edition. I don't know what that means, but I heard some of the pieces sold out online within 6 hours. And I know the boutique has been slammed. I don't even think they're taking orders to ship to other states unless you've shopped with them before. But this is the box. Pair of sunglasses, and I'm sure it's not truly a surprise because I took so many pictures and videos wearing these sunglasses. We just had a moment. I tried them on and it was love. These are not new. In fact, I don't know when they came out with them, but I'm sure I've seen them plenty of times. I've probably even tried them on and I just disregarded them. So it looks sort of like the Chanel chain that you'd see on a Chanel purse, but then from the side, it also looks like little CCs. And I just thought that was really cool. So these are the Shield sunglasses. I believe they are still available online. This style is far trendier than anything else I have in my collection. I typically don't go for the styles like this because they are a bit trendier, and I just prefer something really classic. I like to think down the road, what will I be happy wearing in a couple years, 5 years, 10 years, if I can imagine myself wearing it for a really long time and I just think they're my personal style, not really trendy, then I'll go for it. These I think are pretty trendy, but because they have this kind of classic Chanel CC chain design, I think they'll always be pretty cool. Let me show you what they look like on the face. They fit pretty tight, which I love. It is so hard finding sunglasses to fit my skinny head. So the fact that they went on and they felt really comfortable, but also like they were really gripping my head, that was a good thing. That's another reason why I went ahead and picked them up. I have a pair of sunglasses I picked up, I think maybe 2 years ago. I've been wearing them a lot lately, and the sides are very thick, and I find that they're not that comfortable after a while. So I need something that's comfortable. I liked the thin sides. This is the first time I've tried them on since purchasing, and I do really like them. I think they look so cool. They're probably too cool for me, if I'm being honest, but I kind of like that they're different from what I'm used to. I do think you lose the impact when you're not wearing an all-black outfit. I could see myself wearing these with maybe jeans or shorts and a white top or all-black outfit. I think it needs to be very sleek and smart. I don't like them with the pop of color. I think it needs to be an all-white, black outfit situation. The real selling point is honestly how comfortable they are to wear. They fit perfectly and they feel really light. That completes my June favorites and little Chanel haul. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Leave me your comments, questions down below. As always, I will be linking everything mentioned, everything on my face, down in the description box for your convenience, including the information on the Ana Luisa summer sale, 20% off site-wide. I hope everybody has an incredible holiday weekend. Be safe if you're celebrating, and I'll see you in my next one.